Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with chapter 32, prepositions of your grammar magic book. So all of you open your book at page number 115. So today we are going to learn what is a preposition and use of preposition. Before starting, let me discuss few examples with you. He sat the chair. Second, there is some milk in the fridge. Third, she was hiding the table. Now you can see in all these three sentences, one part of speech is not showing the relationship with the other part of speech. Like in our first sentence, he sat the chair. Here pronoun he is not showing any relationship with the noun chair, that where he was sitting. Second, there is some milk in the fridge. Now here noun milk is not showing any relationship with the other noun fridge. Third one, she was hiding the table. Now here pronoun she was not showing any relationship with the noun table. But if we add prepositions, then these sentences will look like this. First one, he sat on the chair. Now here on indicates the relationship of pronoun he with noun chair. So on is your preposition. It indicates the relationship and the position that he was sitting on the chair. Second, there is some milk in the fridge. Here in indicates the relationship of noun milk with the other noun fridge. So in is your preposition. Third one, she was hiding under the table. Now under in the sentence indicates the relationship of pronoun she with the noun table. So it is a preposition. So preposition. And if we bifurcate preposition, it will become pre plus position. Preposition is a word that tells the position. What is a preposition? A preposition is a word that shows a relationship between a noun or pronoun and another word in a sentence. Preposition usually come before a noun and give information about time, place, or direction. A preposition is a word that indicates the position. See this example. The planets revolve around the sun. Now here, around is your preposition as it tells the position and it shows the relationship between two nouns, that is planets and sun. Now various types of prepositions. There are three types of preposition: when, where and in which direction. Means preposition of time. Where means preposition of place, and in which direction means preposition of direction. Today we are going to learn various prepositions of place. Look at these examples. The books are on the table. Here on tells the position that where books are lying, and it shows the relationship between two nouns, books and table. So on is a preposition and it tells you the place of book, so it is a preposition of place. Second example, the plane is just below cloud. Here below tells you the position of the plane, so it is a preposition of place. In, on, under, these are also preposition of place. Like the cat is in the jar. Here in tells you the position of cat, so it is a preposition of place. On, the cat is on the jar. It tells you the position of the cat, that it is on the jar, so it is a preposition of place. Under, the cat is under the jar. Here under tells you the position of the cat, that it is under the jar, so it is a preposition of place. Other preposition of place are on, above, over, beside, below, under, behind, etc. Today we are going to focus on three prepositions of place, that is on, over and above. Now let us discuss use of on, over and above. On, covering something, part of the surface. So this definition tells us that on means that one thing is covering something else. It usually touches the surface. Means if we use preposition on, it means that the one thing is touching the surface. Like you can see in the picture, a ball is placed on a box. So here ball is touching the surface of a box. So it is showing that a ball is on the box. Now look at the examples. Most people put butter on their toast. Here butter indicates the relationship with the toast, means butter is touching the surface of the toast, so we use the preposition on here. Put your jacket on before you go outside. I wear my grandmother's ring on my left ring finger. Here ring is touching the surface of a finger, so we use on here. Now look at more examples. I put an egg on the kitchen table. Now here on is telling the position or the place where an egg was. So it is telling the relationship between an egg and the table. So it is a preposition of place. Second, the paper is on my desk. On is telling you the position that where paper is lying. It is lying on my desk, so it is a preposition of place. Third one, the stick hit me on my shoulder. Fourth, the girl is sitting on the chair. Over, covering, on top of. This definition tells us that over means that one thing is covering or laying on the top of something else. As you can see in the picture, that dark orange thing is lying on the top of light orange box. It is not touching the surface of light orange box. It is somewhat at a height than the box. So over is used when one thing is not touching the surface of the other thing. Let us discuss examples. She is wearing a sundress over her swimsuit. It means she was wearing a swimsuit and over it she wear a sundress also. So we used preposition over here. Second one, we flew over the Grand Canyon. Here over would suggest movement from one side to the other. Now look at more examples. The birds flew over the houses. Means the birds were flying over the houses. The bridge is over the sea. Second, the cover is over the vegetables. Means we have put a cover over the vegetables and it is at a higher position. It is not touching the surface. So we used over here and it is a preposition of place. Next, the cow jumped over the fence. Now third one, above, in a higher place. Above is usually something that is higher than something else, such as tree above a yard. As you can see in the picture, a ball is above the box. It is at somewhat at a height, means it is higher than the box. Now let us discuss few examples. We are above the Grand Canyon. Above here suggests we are currently above the Grand Canyon. Ben lives above the pizza shop, means his apartment is located on the top of the pizza shop. Above is used when something is at the highest. Above is used somewhat at a height than the over. Now look at more examples. A dark cloud was above the house. Here the clouds are above the house, means at a higher distance. The water rose above his neck. We saw a bird flying far above the building. The lamp is above the table. Now these are the examples how we can use on, over and above in a sentence. So we use the words on, over and above depending on how high the object or person is. See this picture. On is used when something is touching the surface. Over is used when something is above the other thing, means at a something at a high position, and above is used when something is at the highest. So now I hope all of you have come to know that what is a preposition and the uses of prepositions in a sentence. So, on the basis of today's session, you people are going to revise your chapter 32 prepositions and work as per your schedule of your SNAP homework, plus you need to solve the exercises related to it. Goodbye. Thank you.